Hello everyone, welcome to Adobe Barong, and I am RayRay, and today we're gonna do the vocal processing tutorial and I'm gonna do the emotional violence this track with Skellism, because apparently a lot of people, they are very curious about this vocal, and it's a very dope track, and shout out to Skellism too. So I'm gonna record my vocal. I'm gonna re-sing the track. I'll try my best to do that, because apparently I'm not allowed to use my Apple. So I'll try my best to re-record it. And also, it's not gonna be perfect because of I don't have headphone. But and also, I'm gonna show you guys my vocal chain, and you will know like how do I process my vocal. And if you like it, you can take it from me. All right. So right now I got the instrumental here. This is the original version. I'm gonna play here. There's no vocal on it yet. Okay, so you can tell I'm not the perfect singer. Sometimes I have really pitchy voice, but I always use auto-tune. If you don't crank too much, auto-tune can sound really natural as well. So we'll see later. All right, so right now I'm going to record my vocal. I'm gonna re-sing this track, and I'm gonna start from zero so you can see how I normally do with my vocal. Let's go. So now we are going to listen to the vocal I just recorded completely dry.
I know the truth might be something about you.
It's pretty clean though. Okay, let's find the key first. I remember it's an E key. Normally I find key like this. Alright. It's B actually. What I remember is E. Alright, never mind. So B. So there's a RayRay vocal chain. Number 5. That's what I normally use. So B. So it sounds like a minor. So I use auto-tune on my vocal because I'm not the perfect singer, and I'm still working on my singing, but it's getting better. Well, it's actually really good right now. No, it's getting better. And but I'm still put auto-tune on it because sometimes when I sing the higher voice, it can get pitchy, so auto-tune actually helped me with that. But I don't crank everything up, so you can see the numbers here. So normally when it's close to very auto-tune, you put the return speed to zero, and you put the flex tune speed to zero as well. Then this is like super auto-tune, you can hear from here. Let me do it now.
I know the truth might be something about you.
See, that's like super auto-tune.
I can't.
We don't want that unless you make a special track with like a lot of auto-tune, that you can do that. Humanize, I always put it to 100 because I want it to sound more human. And natural vibrato around 3.4, that's what I normally do. Sometimes I don't adjust this, but today I'm gonna put it at 3.4, so you can have the vibrato in your voice when you sing longer notes. Return speed, I'm gonna go back to what I do. I normally do it at 2 o'clock, and flex tune I do it at 10 o'clock. So that's here.
I know the truth might be something about you. I can't deny the devil inside of my mind.
Alright, sounds not bad.
You can't save my soul. All that we had broken to pieces. Just grab my hand, grab my hand. All that we need is a little more violence.
Alright, still. Oh, everything's on right now, so sorry about that. I'm gonna turn everything off. So that's why you hear the big crush, because I got a big crush on here right now. I'm gonna turn everything off. So sorry about that. Alright, but because I record with the speaker on, so you might hear like a little bit noise in the background, so we need to cut it off. And also, we have AC on right here, so also you can record that as well. So don't forget to turn off your AC while you are recording in your room. Normally turn on OTT just to make sure I hear the noise. So I'm gonna do this step. I'm gonna cut all the noise out, but make sure you don't cut on your vocal.
I know.
I'm gonna crank it up for a bit so I can just get here.
I know.
All right, I'm gonna delete this. Normally I don't like the breathing voice, but when it comes to like really sad tracks, I will keep some of the breathing voice in it, but right now I'm just gonna delete everything. Okay, now we delete all the empty part, the noise part in the vocal. Now I'm gonna adjust OTT. Alright, so OTT, there are actually no rules for it. So I normally just listen to the instrumental, listen to the music you made, and then just adjust it to a point that you feel okay with it, you are cool with it. So now I feel like this isn't enough for now, but be careful, I'm gonna put COA after. It's also kind of like OTT, the compressor, so it's gonna make everything loud, even more louder. So for now it's okay, and now I'm turning on my COA.
I know.
Alright, I'm turned off for now, and you hear?
I know.
This is just OTT, and then COA. So I don't crank that much because I know I have a COA after.
I know the truth.
Now your vocal sounds more compressed.
Might be something about you.
I turned off the bass. I turned off the bass. And then normally treble and compress, I will go up very high. And delay and revert off pitch also.
You can't.
Now it sounds really good. And the crazy part is I put another compressor on it after COA.
I know.
Even more compressed now.
The truth might be something about you.
Now it's very dry but compressed.
But I can't.
I need to turn on EQ too.
Deny.
So for EQ, your vocal doesn't need the sub, the bass part, the lower frequency. So I just cut around like 300 to 400 part, and around 200 to 300 from 400 part, depends on like your vocal frequency. My vocal is like this, and go up a little bit on 100k, so it made my vocal more thicker.
I know the truth might be something about you.
It already sounds really nice. So for the big crush, ignore it. You don't need it for this song. Like I put, sometimes I have a big crush on preset because sometimes I want my vocal to sound really crispy and crazy. So I have this, but you don't need it for this song. So I'm just gonna, and then now I'm making a group because sometimes you will need, I will record a backing vocal for this. I'm gonna do it later, but it's gonna be a trick I normally do, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. I usually have Ableton, so I put group, so I put my vocal reverb and delay on here. So stop laughing. Normally I do that, but you guys were making fun of me because there we don't need to send bars on Ableton. Okay, Ricky was making fun of me of this because they was like checking my project, or a few days ago, a few weeks ago, and then they was like, what the fuck, you don't send bus on your vocal? And then I say, on Ableton, we use group, that's not bus. And I was like, I was like really confused. But anyway, this is the Ableton bus. All right, anyway, I use Valhalla a lot, actually. So I'm gonna go with this one first. You know, I don't use any preset, I just adjust it myself. And I always use Lightroom. I always turn the pre-delay really, how to say that? Small, low, yeah. And a hike up, depth up. Decay, depends on your track. This one is like really emotional track, so maybe decay, I can go up a little bit. Let's hear. I know the truth might be something about you. I can't deny. Alright, sound good now. I also use Supermassive as well. And I have my crazy preset called Cool as Fuck. And it just make everything sound dope. Right. I know the truth might be. If you guys wanna copy this preset, just pause the video and then you can get the numbers on the preset. So this is called Cool as Fuck. So you can also call it Cool as Fuck. I still hear some mistake from the dry vocal. So normally when I work on my vocal project, I won't just do one tag. I will do multiple tag. If that part, that sentence, I don't do it right, I will do it again and again and again until it's right. So because it's a production, so it's not the live. So we are allowed to do as many times as we want until it's perfect. Normally I put another EQ after everything's compressed, just cut off the unnecessary frequency on the vocal. So this one just like a simple adjustment that you can always do that. It's actually a preset and I adjust it. I can't deny the devil inside. All right, so backing vocal is very interesting. Depends on what song you are making for this track. I want it to be very clean, so I only do one tag. When it comes to the build up or like the part of like you need more energy, I will double up my vocal, because one layer is not enough. It sounds like really thin. So which part is you can? You can. All right, this part. I'll double it right here, but I'm gonna turn low a bit. Okay, so it's very interesting that your vocal, you can go -5. That's like perfect harmony for your vocal most of the time. So now we will sound. You can't save my soul, although we have transposed to -5. Broken to pieces. Just grab my hand, grab my hand. All that we need is a little more violence. I don't re-record one more take for this because I want it to be very organized. Everything sounds the same, so I use the previous take. And now I use Nectars. I'm gonna turn it on, and I believe it's on the clear background vox preset, but today we don't need that. We need a very even cooler one. Let me find it. 1-4 background, because this is a cool one. But I'm gonna turn off the reverb because I already have reverb on the bus. This is my voice. Alright. Compressors on, EQ on. Alright, there's one more thing. It's called wider, so I put it like around 50 because this is the lower voice, and then I want it to be a little bit outside of the main vocal, so I use wider. This is very fun plugin. I think you guys should all go get it. So now the vocal sounds like you can't thicker. Save my soul. Okay, sounds good. So let's play with the track. The devil inside my mind. So that's pretty much that's normally I process my vocal, and also if you want to make it more crazier with the backing vocals and ad libs, everything, just more layers, but you need to be extra careful with the frequency, because like your voice is always on the same frequency, and also the delay and reverb, you don't want it to sound more too messy and then fuck up the whole track. Yeah, this is Emotional Violence. So if you haven't checked out this track, it's already out on Barong Family with Skellism, and also I'm dropping a new EP. I don't know when this video will be out, but yeah, it's called Alien Mutation. It's also on Barong Family 4 tracks. I hope you will enjoy it. Don't forget to leave the comments under, and also subscribe the channel, and also like this video. Looking forward to see you guys soon. Bye!